So good morning everyone, this is Dharambir sir here. So today we are going to start chapter 7 of grade 12 maths, that is integrals. So this is the second part of grade 12 maths. So today we are going to learn about the basics of integration, or I can say that the introduction of integration. Clear? So let's start. So first let me tell you what is integration. Integration is just the opposite of differentiation, or I can say that integration is can be called as the anti-differentiation. Now in case of integration, we are given differentiation of a function and we have to find the original function, that is the primitive. So in case of differentiation, we are given a function and we used to find its differential. Now in case of integration, we will be given the differentiation of the function and we have to find its primitive function, that is the original function. Clear? So the process through which you find the original function or the primitive is called integration or anti-differentiation. Now let me give you some examples. As you can see that I have written d upon dx of sin x is equal to what? Cos x. Differentiation of e power x is e power x, and differentiation of x cube upon 3, if you differentiate it, it will be equal to what? X square. Clear? Now we all know that the function cos x is the derived function of sin x. Then we say that this sin x is the antiderivative or the integral of cos x. Clear? I am clear. Now we know that the differentiation of any constant is always zero. So if we write the above three that I have written, differentiation of sin x plus c will be cos x. Differentiation of e power x plus c will be e power x, and differentiation of x cube upon 3 plus c will be x square. So antiderivative of the above examples are not unique, because different, we have to add constant to integral, because different constants will, if in place of c we write 0, 5, minus 7, whatever we write, we are going to get the same derivative. So I can conclude that there exist infinitely many antiderivatives of each of the functions, so which can be obtained by choosing c. So we have to compulsorily write c whenever we have to find the integral in the final answer, and this c is called the arbitrary constant. Now let me introduce the symbol. As you can say that I have written integral of fx dx, which represent the entire class of antiderivatives, read as the integral of f with respect to x. So if it was fy dy, then it should be written as integral of f with respect to y. Clear? Next, I'm giving you some symbols and different terms related to integrals. In the first one, we have integral fx dx, which is read as integral of f with respect to x. Now in integral of fx, this fx is the integrand which we have to integrate, and x in integral fx is the variable of the integration. Integrate means we have to find the integral, an integral of f, so a function f such that f dash x equals to fx. Clear? Integration, so integration is the process of finding the integral, and constant of integration, as discussed, any real number c will be considered as the constant function. Like the differentiation, we have some standard integrals which I am giving below. So pause and note down these integrals or antiderivatives of the standard functions. Few more antiderivatives of integrals, you can see that we have trigonometric functions and inverse trigonometric function here. So note down the antiderivatives of or the integrals of the trigonometric and inverse trigonometric functions. Here we have some more inverse trigonometric functions and exponential as well as the logarithmic functions. So note down the integrals of exponential and the logarithmic functions. So next we have some properties of indefinite integral. Indefinite means we are adding constant every time. That is why I am saying indefinite, because this c can be any real number. So the integral of sum of two functions, integral of sum of two functions, that is integral of fx plus gx, will be equal to the sum of the integrals of the individual function. That is integral of fx plus gx will be equal to integral of fx plus integral of gx. सेम विल बी द केस ऑफ माइनस इंटीग्रल ऑफ एफ एक्स माइनस जी एक्स विल बी इक्वल टू इंटीग्रल ऑफ एफ एक्स प्लस माइनस इंटीग्रल ऑफ जी एक्स एंड अ कॉन्स्टेंट फैक्टर मे बी रिटर्न इधर बिफोर और आफ्टर द इंटीग्रल साइन दैट इज इफ वी हैव इंटीग्रल ऑफ ए एफ एक्स डी एक्स वेयर ए इज सम कॉन्स्टेंट देन वी कैन टेक द कॉन्स्टेंट ए आउटसाइड द इंटीग्रल एंड राइट इट एज ए इंटीग्रल एफ एक्स क्लियर सपोज एंड नोट डाउन द प्रॉपर्टीज सो लेट्स बिगिन विथ एक्सरसाइज 7.1 सो क्वेश्चन इज फाइंड द एंटी डेरिवेटिव और इंटीग्रल ऑफ द फॉलोइंग फंक्शन बाई द मेथड ऑफ इंस्पेक्शन फर्स्ट इज यू हैव साइन एक्स नाउ द एंटी डेरिवेटिव ऑफ साइन 2x इज अ फंक्शन हुज डेरिवेटिव इज साइन 2x वी हैव लर्न अबाउट एंटी डेरिवेटिव नाउ वी नो दैट डिफरेंशिएशन ऑफ कॉस 2x विल बी वॉट साइन 2x एंड माइनस 2 बट वी नीड ओनली साइन 2x सो वी हैव साइन 2x इक्वल्स टू वॉट माइनस हाफ इंटू डी अपॉन डी एक्स ऑफ कॉस 2x therefore sin 2x is equal to differentiation of minus half into cos 2x now since sin 2x is the differentiation of this function minus half cos 2x so this minus half cos 2x is the antiderivative or the integral of the given function sin 2x it's very simple think of the number whose derivative is the given function clear so pause and note down the solution next we have question 3 find the antiderivative of e power 2x now we know that the antiderivative of e power 2x is the function whose derivative will be e power 2x we know that differentiation of e power 2x is equal to what 2 into e power 2x but we need only e power 2x so dividing to this side we will get e power 2x equals to half into differentiation of e power 2x that is e power 2x is the differentiation of half e power 2x so by the definition we can conclude that the antiderivative of e power antiderivative of or integral of e power 2x will be half into e power 2x clear so pause and note down the solution next we have question 5 that is find the antiderivative or integral of sin 2x minus 4 e power 3x now here we have two functions sin 2x and minus 4 e power 3x so the antiderivative of sin 2x minus 4 e power 3x will be some function whose derivative will be the given function Now we know that differentiation of minus half cos 2x by taking sin 2x and minus 4 by 3 e power 3x by taking minus 4 e power 3x is equal to the given function. So by the definition of antiderivative, the integral or antiderivative of sin 2x minus 4 e power 3x will be minus half cos 2x minus 4 by 3 e power 3x. Clear? So pause and note down the solution. Next is question number 6 find the integral of 4 e power 3x plus 1 dx clear now we know that constant can be taken out of the integral so taking 4 outside we are getting 4 integral of e power 3x dx plus integral of 1 dx and we know that integral of e power 3x will be what e power 3x upon 3 because if you differentiate e power 3x upon 3 you are getting e power 3x clear and differentiation of 1 sorry integral of 1 we know that the differentiation of x is equal to 1 so integral of 1 will be equal to x and we have learned that we have to add c for every integral so adding c so we are getting our final answer as 4 upon 3 e power 3x plus x plus c it is very simple if you know the differentiation you can easily find the derivative so pause and note down the solution next is question 7 find the integral of x square 1 minus 1 upon x square dx clear so first I am opening the bracket so multiplying x square into the bracket we are getting integral of x square into 1 minus half x 1 upon x square dx equals to integral x square minus 1 dx now applying the property that integral of x square dx minus 1 dx and integral of x square will be what x cube upon 3 minus integral of 1 will be x minus x plus we have to add the arbitrary constant now this x square integral of x square is from if you have learned the properties that if we have to integrate x power n it is x power n plus 1 upon n plus 1 clear so learn the property that I have given in the beginning then the differentiation will be very easy so integration will be very easy so pause and note down the solution next we have question 10 find the integral of under root x minus 1 upon root x ka whole square So we have integral of root x minus 1 upon root x whole square dx. So applying a minus b whole square, we are getting integral x plus 1 upon x minus 2 dx. Now applying the property, that is this, the integral can be written as integral of x dx plus integral of 1 upon x dx minus 2 is constant. So taking 2 outside, we will get minus 2 integral 1 dx. So integral of x is x square upon 2. Using the property x power n equals to x power n plus 1 upon n plus 1. And integral of 1 upon x is log modulus x. Don't forget to log modulus x, it will be very good. But it is not compulsory. Let me tell you, it is not compulsory to write log modulus x. If you are writing log x, it is okay. But make it a habit to write log mod x in case of integration. Minus 2 into integral of 1. Integral of 1 is what? X. And adding the arbitrary constant c, you will get our desired integral. Clear? So pause and note down the solution. Next we have question 12. Find the integral of x cube plus 3x plus 4 upon root x dx. So this integral can be written as dividing the numerator by root x. That is dividing the numerator by denominator. We'll get this integral equals to integral of x power 5 by 2 plus 3x power half plus 4x power minus half. Clear? I hope you are clear that we have divided the numerator by the denominator, that is root x. Now the given integral can be written as the addition of different integrals, that integral of x power 5 by 2 plus integral of 3x power half plus integral of 4x minus half. Clear? So applying the x power n plus 1 upon n plus 1 formula, we'll get x power 7 by 2 upon 7 by 2 plus 3x power 3 by 2 upon 3 by 2 plus 4x power half upon half plus the constant of integral c. So simplifying the solution, we'll get 2 upon 7 x power 7 by 2 plus 2x power 3 by 2 plus 8 root x plus c. So in this sum we applied only one property, that is integral of x power n is equal to what? X power n plus 1 upon n plus 1. I hope I'm clear. So pause and note down the solution. Next we have question 13. Find the integral of x cube minus x square plus x minus 1 upon x minus 1 dx. So there are two methods. Either factorize the numerator to solve the given integral or divide the numerator by denominator. So if you divide the numerator by denominator, you will get x square plus 1. So we have the given integral equal to integral x square plus 1 dx. And then applying the property, that integral of fx plus gx was what? Integral of fx plus integral of gx. So we have integral of x square dx plus integral of 1 dx. And integral of x square will be what? By applying the formula of integral of x power n, it will be x cube upon 3 plus integral of 1 is what? X plus constant of integration c. Clear? So pause and note down the solution. Next we have question 15. Find the integral of root x multiplied by 3x square plus 2x plus 3 dx. So multiplying root x throughout the bracket, we will get the integral equals to integral 3x power 5 by 2 plus 2x power 3 by 2 plus 3x power half. Now we have integral of fx plus gx plus hx. So applying the property, we will get 3 integral x power 5 by 2 dx plus 2 integral x power 3 by 2 2x plus 3 integral x power half dx. Now here everything is in the form of x power n, and integral of x power n is equal to x power n plus 1 upon n plus 1. So we'll get 3 x power 7 by 2 upon 7 by 2 plus 2 x power 5 by 2 upon 5 by 2 plus 3 x power 3 by 2 upon 3 by 2 plus constant of integration c. So after simplification we'll get 6 upon 7 x power 7 by 2 plus 4 upon 5 x power 5 by 2 plus 2x power 3 by 2 plus constant of integration c. Clear? So pause and note down the solution. Next we have question 18. Find the following integral. Integral of sec x multiplied by sec x plus tan x dx. So if you multiply sec x in the bracket, we will get integral of sec square x plus integral of sec x tan x. So again we have fx plus gx. So we'll have integral of sec square x dx plus integral of sec x tan x dx. Now think of the function whose derivative is sec square x. It is tan x. So integral of sec square x dx will be tan x. And we have to think of the function whose derivative is sec x tan x. So it is sec x. Clear? So integral of sec x tan x is equal to what? Sec x. And adding the integral of constant of integration c, विल गेट आवर फाइनल आंसर एज 10x प्लस सेक एक्स प्लस सी. क्लियर? सो पॉज एंड नोट डाउन द सॉल्यूशन. नेक्स्ट वी हैव क्वेश्चन नंबर 19. फाइंड द इंटीग्रल ऑफ इंटीग्रल सेक्स स्क्वायर एक्स अपॉन कॉस एक्स स्क्वायर एक्स डी एक्स. सो राइटिंग सेक्स स्क्वायर एक्स एज वन अपॉन कॉस स्क्वायर एंड कॉस एक्स स्क्वायर एज वन अपॉन साइन स्क्वायर. वी विल गेट इंटीग्रल ऑफ साइन स्क्वायर एक्स अपॉन कॉस स्क्वायर एक्स डी एक्स एंड विच इज इक्वल टू इंटीग्रल ऑफ टेन स्क्वायर एक्स डी एक्स. नाउ वी डोंट हैव द इंटीग्रेशन ऑफ टेन स्क्वायर एक्स. सो राइटिंग टेन स्क्वायर एक्स इन द फॉर्म ऑफ सेक्स स्क्वायर एक्स माइनस वन. वी नो द प्रॉपर्टी. क्लियर? सो इन प्लेस ऑफ टेन स्क्वायर एक्स आई रिटर्न सेक्स स्क्वायर एक्स माइनस वन इंटू डी एक्स. नाउ यूजिंग द प्रॉपर्टी द इंटीग्रल ऑफ एफ एक्स प्लस जी एक्स विल गेट इंटीग्रल ऑफ सेक्स स्क्वायर एक्स डी एक्स माइनस इंटीग्रल वन डी एक्स. एंड वी नो दैट इंटीग्रल ऑफ सेक्स स्क्वायर एक्स इज वॉट टेन एक्स. सो इन प्लेस ऑफ इंटीग्रल ऑफ सेक्स स्क्वायर एक्स डी एक्स वी हैव टेन एक्स एंड इंटीग्रल ऑफ वन विल बी एक्स. सो इट इज माइनस एक्स प्लस सी. सो हियर वी हैव यूज सम ट्रिग्नोमेट्रिक आइडेंटिटीज. क्लियर? सो पॉज एंड नोट डाउन द सॉल्यूशन. नेक्स्ट वी हैव क्वेश्चन नंबर 20. फाइंड द इंटीग्रल ऑफ इंटीग्रल 2 माइनस 3 साइन एक्स अपॉन कॉस स्क्वायर एक्स डी एक्स. सो वी कैन राइट द गिवन इंटीग्रल एज इंटीग्रल 2 अपॉन कॉस स्क्वायर एक्स माइनस 3 साइन एक्स अपॉन कॉस स्क्वायर एक्स डी एक्स. सो अगेन अप्लाइंग द ट्रिग्नोमेट्रिक प्रॉपर्टीज विल गेट इंटीग्रल 2 सेक्स स्क्वायर एक्स बिकॉज 1 अपॉन कॉस स्क्वायर एक्स इज सेक्स स्क्वायर एक्स माइनस 3 टेन एक्स सेक एक्स बिकॉज 1 साइन एक्स अपॉन कॉस इज टेन एंड 1 अपॉन कॉस विल बी सेक. क्लियर? Now we have to apply the integral in sec square and we know that integral of sec square x is what? 10x minus 3 and integral of 10x sec x is sec x plus c. So learn the property that I have given in the beginning of the video. If you learn the property, then these integrations are very simple. So pause and note down the solution of the given question. So I hope I am clear with the exercise. So solve the remaining sums of exercise 7.1. And also solve the examples before this exercise. Yeah? Thank you and all the best.